My friends, good to see you back here. And today we will do another burger Italian style. Have a look.
Wow, look at this burger. Guacamole burger, of course, with homemade guacamole. And the patties made of organic beef of happy cows grown here in Italy.
And you got it again right. It's a guacamole burger. So basically a burger with guacamole, homemade guacamole. You may think guacamole is this Italian. It comes originally from Mexico, that's right, and the only ingredient that we use not from Italy will be avocado. All the other ingredients will be Italian. So let's have a look what exactly this will be. So talking about the guacamole, as I said, you will use one avocado. We will use a special Italian cream cheese type, a stracchino as it called. And we will do it together with a little piece of garlic. So that will be the guacamole. For the actual patties, we will use this organic beef from happy Italian cows. Very, very delicious. We have used it in the past and it's from my trusted butcher. So for the patties, you will use about 500 grams of this. A little bit of fine breadcrumbs. You will add a little shot of red wine. Then the standard stuff, salt, pepper, muscat nuts, and also the very famous coriander from my garden, very fresh. I just grabbed it. We will also add a shot of mustard, and that will be the patty. We will fry them in olive oil. I forgot to put the olive oil bottle here. So we will fry the patties in olive oil on medium flame. And as a side dish, I chose my preferred chips. I don't want to make too much today. And also very important, when you eat burger, you need proper adult beverage. So we got this also here. And I would say, let's start. Okay, my friends. And of course, I forgot to mention the olive oil. We will also add this into the guacamole. And so this will also make it very, very Italian flavored. So first step will be cutting the skin of this guacamole. Let me do it this way. Yeah, it's very mature, so we can do it this way. There are different techniques to cut this guacamole, but today I chose this technique. The other technique would have been that you cut it like this together with the skin, but it will also work like this. And I will make my fingers a little dirty. So we'll do a little break. I will clean my fingers and then we'll continue with the next step. Ah, there you are. Okay. So the good thing about these creative breaks are I can think about what I have forgotten. Of course, we will also add a little bit of this homegrown rosemary for the patties. But let's get back to the guacamole. So we got here the stracchino. I will just open it and we will not use all, but perhaps I would say about half of it, or a little bit more than half. So this is 200 grams. A little bit more of half would be 120 grams, like this. We will also delicious. You'll also add one piece of garlic, very, very fine, because we don't want to bite on this garlic, but we want the taste. My fingers are now a bit wet from this stracchino, but we will get there. There we go. So first the horizontal cut and now the vertical cut. Very, very thin slices. And once we have all cut, we will mix it all together, together with a little bit of salt also and olive oil. Okay, so you see we got the garlic on it. I will add a little bit of salt. There we go. And since I'm there, we can also add a little bit of pepper, black pepper, a shot of olive oil. Yeah, so this will become a very, very delicious guacamole Italian style, inspired by Mexico and finalized here in Italy with Italian ingredients. Again, the only non-Italian ingredient is this avocado. They do not really grow here. And
I will continue doing like this and we will see you back in a few minutes. Okay, my friends, so you see this beautiful, very green avocado guacamole, and with a little bit of poking with this fork, I managed to create this beautiful and delicious avocado guacamole. And let me do a quality check. It's incredible. It's really incredible. This is how it's supposed to be like. So yeah, let's move on with the patties. So I will take this fresh cut minced beef, quality organic stuff. I will add a little shot of red wine, perhaps the final shot of this bottle. Yeah, there we go. I will move this aside for a moment. I will start cutting my homegrown coriander. There we go. This comes into the patties. I will also start cutting my homegrown rosemary. So it really helps when you have a garden and you have access to these fresh ingredients. They will definitely add value whenever you cook something. And apart from the fact that you will save some money in buying all this stuff. So here we go. Next is pepper. Pepper does not grow yet here. There we go. A little bit of salt. You see a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Fine breadcrumbs, I would say 50 grams. This is enough to make the patties a little bit softer. And finally, the Muscat nuts. There we go. And, oh yes, we also add some Italian mustard. There we go. And now I got my fingers sanitized, clean. I start mixing this all together. And then we can start forming the patties. See, it's really, really easy. You don't trust me. Just be a little bit creative. Take a little bit time. It does not take much time. We are here at Simple Italian Cooking, and everything I propose to you is very simple. If you just watch the video from the beginning till the end, even with very basic cooking skills, you will be able to recook the dishes as I do. All right, so let's start creating the patties. Let me see if this is a reasonable size. Yeah, I think so. So you do this all with your hands. You don't need any particular device. I mean, if you had one, it would be good. It would be good to have. I don't, so I just do it this old school style. And yeah, will be fine. See, one. First make them very dense so they don't fall apart. That's actually also a reason why I have added the fine breadcrumbs. They will help keeping the meat stick together with the other ingredients. There we go. Okay, my friends, so another milestone has been reached. After the guacamole, we have also prepared the patties. We got four patties out of these 500-600 grams, and you can now make a guess which of those patties I will eat first. Exactly, this one, yeah. And meanwhile, I've already started heating up the olive oil on medium flame. And breaking news, one thing I forgot to mention, of course, when we do burgers, of course, we will also need bread, our buns. And today I've chosen this kind of bread. I think this is very suitable. And yeah, let's move on. I will throw in, yes, I will throw. It's not really super hot yet, but I will already start throwing it in. Two at a time, and then we will see. Okay, we are pretty much there. Let's see if I can turn the patties around. Hopla. Excuse me, cameraman. woman. Okay, yeah, we'll turn them around one more time after this, so we get them golden on both sides. Meanwhile, I have already cut the tomatoes for the patty, and I will show you why, because we will already add on the buns the guacamole on both sides, on the bottom side and on the top side, because it needs to look, not only look, really taste also really really creamy, although we are not using really cream, but we want the full guacamole flavor on this burger. Guacamole and meat is always a very good match. There we go. Right, we're almost there. This is about 10 minutes of frying on low flame on olive oil. You see, I also put some little tomatoes on the guacamole, so they stick well together. Look at this magic. And we are soon ready to eat. Let me also try these chips. Yeah, really good. Let's put some of those on the plate. We also want those. There we go. All right, so I like it medium. And so this looks very medium, with a little brown touch, and I'm ready to eat the first burger. There we go.
Wow, look at this burger, guacamole burger, of course with homemade guacamole, and the patties made of organic beef of happy cows grown here in Italy.
Wow. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. Thanks for this. If you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comments field. Also down there on this side, you can subscribe. There will come many, many, many more videos. This is just the very beginning. And let's do the ultimate test and see how this guacamole burger tastes like. This is finger food.